Dear students, welcome to EPG Paathshala. Today I am presenting module Soil Formation. The soil formation is also known as pedogenesis, and as we all know, all the soil comes from the rock and termed as parent material. Now this parent material, when undergo chemical and physical weathering, transported and located, is termed as transformed soil. The formation of soil, it can also be seen as the product of weathering. Then after weathering, the structural formation of soil takes place. After the formation of the structure of soil, it will undergo the process of formation of horizons or layering. Then the movement and translocation of soil takes place. In the soil physical and chemical weathering, climatic conditions also plays very important role. On the other hand, water, it also plays important role by showing its involvement in soil development through dissolution, precipitation, erosion, transportation and deposition. The soil is also having three phases: solid, liquid and gaseous phase. Moreover, the soil scientists, they prefer to include five important components while studying the soil formation. And these components are parent material, organisms, time, climate and relief. On the other hand, soil also contains five important components which are very important for the healthy soil. Now we take the process of soil formation. Soil formation develops as a result of interplay of five factors which I have already told, as parent material, climate, organism, relief and time. Now first we'll take the parent material. This is the material from which the soil has developed and can vary from solid rocks to deposits. It has been defined as the initial state of soil system. The parent material can influence the soil in number of ways. For example, color, texture, structure, mineral composition, permeability. This soil has developed an old red sandstone and so has derived its distinguished color from its parent material, as shown in the figure. Climate. This is probably the most important factor. Climate governs the rate and type of soil formation and is also the main determinant of vegetation distribution. On the other hand, temperature determines the rate of reaction, chemical and biological decay, and so has influence on weathering and humification of the soil. Third, that is our organisms, which play important role in soil formation. Organisms influence soil development range from microscopic bacteria to large animals including man. Microorganisms such as bacteria and fungi assist in the decomposition of plant litter. This litter is mixed into the soil by macroorganisms such as our worms and beetles. Soil horizons are less distinct when there is much soil organism activity. Another important point is relief, that is landforms and topography of a particular area. Relief is not static, it is a dynamic system. It influences soil profile thickness. It has an effect on climate, which is also a soil forming factor. Gradient affects runoff, percolation and mass movement. It influences aspect which creates microclimatic conditions of the area. Another important point factor is time. Soil develops very slowly. For example, if we take the example of Britain, it takes about 400 years for 10 mm of soil to develop. Young soil retains many of the characteristics of the parent material. An important feature of soil is that they passes through a number of stages as they develop, resulting in a deep profile with many well differentiated. Now we come to the next process, that is mechanism of soil formation. Soil develops through a series of changes. All soil originates from a parent material, which is a deposit at the surface of earth. Parent material can be withered bedrocks or small materials brought by strong winds, flowing rivers or moving glaciers. The simple compound released by withering becomes food source for soil organisms such as bacteria and fungi. The remains of the dead organisms accumulate in the parent material and turns into organic matter or humus. This slide is showing the soil formation by withering, erosion or deposition processes. Now first we'll take the withering. Withering is the breakdown and alteration of rocks and minerals at the near of the earth's surface into products that are more in equilibrium with the condition found in this environment. Withering is the first step for a number of geomorphic and biogeochemical processes. The product of withering are a major source of sediments for erosion and deposition. Withering also contributes to formation of soil by providing mineral particles like sand, silt and clay. There are three broad categories of mechanism of withering, that is physical, chemical and biological. Now we'll take all these mechanisms one by one. First we'll take chemical withering. Chemical withering involves the alteration of the chemicals and mineralogical composition of withered material. A number of different processes can result in chemical withering. The common chemical withering processes are hydrolysis, oxidation, reduction, hydration, carbonation and solution. Now we'll take one by one these processes. Hydrolysis is the withering of withering reaction that occurs when the two surface of water compound meets. It involves a reaction between mineral ions and the ions of water and results in the decomposition of the rock surface by forming new compounds. Hydrolysis is especially effective in the withering of common silicates and ammonia silicate minerals because of their electrically charged crystal surfaces. Oxidation is the reaction that occurs between the compound and oxygen. The net result of this reaction is the removal of one or more electrons from a compound, which causes the structure to be less rigid and increasingly unstable. The most common oxides are those of iron and aluminium, giving red and yellow staining to the soil and is quite common in tropical regions which have high temperature and precipitation. Now we will take hydration. Hydration involves the rigid attachment of hydrogen and hydronium ions to a reacted compound. In many situations, the hydrogen and hydroxide ions become a structural part of the crystal lattice of the mineral. Next, carbonation is the reaction of carbonate and bicarbonate ions with minerals. The formation of carbonate usually takes place as a result of other chemical processes. Carbonation is specially active when the reaction environment is abundant with carbon dioxide. Another important process, that is now physical withering. Physical withering is the breakdown of minerals or rock material by entirely mechanical methods brought about by a variety of causes. Some of the forces originate within the rock or minerals while others are applied externally. Both of these stresses lead a strain and the rupture of the rock. The process that may cause mechanical rupture are abrasion, wetting and drying and ice formation. The physical breakdown of rock by their expansion and contraction due to the diurnal temperature changes is one of the most keenly debated topic in the rock withering research, also known as insolation weathering. It is the result of the physical inability of rock to conduct heat well. This inability to conduct heat results in differential rates of expansion and contraction. Thus, the surface of the rock expands more than its interior, and this stress will eventually cause rock to rupture. Alternate wetting and drying of rock, sometimes known as slaking, can be a very important factor in withering. Slaking occurs by the mechanism of ordered water, which is the accumulation of successive layers of water molecules in between the mineral grains of the rock. Another process, that is our biological withering. Biological weathering involves the disintegration of rocks and minerals due to the chemical or physical agents of an organism. The types of organisms that can cause weathering range from bacteria to plant to soil, plants to animals. Biochemical processes, root penetration and animal burrowing are some of the processes which are detrimental to this biological weathering process. The organic compounds having acidifying molecules that corrode rock minerals and as such makes them weak and prone to disintegration are also the main types of biological weathering. Some of the main types of biological weathering processes are growing plant roots. It is common to see some roots growing within the face of a rock. Well, such plant activity contributes to biological weathering. The roots of plants and trees penetrate into the soil in search of nutrient and water. As the root penetrates the soil, they go through cracks or joints in the rocks, and as they grow, they progressively crack the rock apart. Bigger growing roots can also exert pressure on the adjacent rocks. Some plant roots also emit organic acids that aid to dissolve the rock material. Another factor, microbial activity. Some plant microbial activity release organic acidic compounds. These compounds can break down iron and aluminium minerals in the rocks. Microscopic organisms like algae, moss, lichens and bacteria are such kind of plant. They grow on the surface of the rocks and produce organic chemicals that are capable of breaking down the outer layer of the rocks by altering the rocks chemical composition. The process of biological weathering, since it is a biological in nature, beside these microscopic organisms are bring about moist chemical microenvironment which encourages the chemical and physical breakdown of the rock surfaces. Burrowing animals also plays important role in biological weathering, such as moles, squirrels and rabbits can speed up the development of fissures. Many animals such as paddock shells drills into the rocks for protection either by releasing acid to dissolve the rocks or fragmenting away the rock grains. These animals' activities can create fissures in the rocks and also eat away the rock minerals. As this process continues, gaps and holes develop within the rocks, further exposing the rocks to chemical, biological and physical weathering. Human activities are also considered to be the important factor in the biological weathering processes. Human activities equally dig, crash and widen the cracks and wind up fragmenting the rock apart. These activities include mining, road construction and housing development. Some of the more important processes during biological weathering, they are the amount of biological activity that break down minerals. It also depends on how much life is in that area. As much as these compounds are produced through biological process, they rise out of biochemical reactions which accelerate chemical and physical weathering. Simple breaking of materials by the consumption of soil particles by animals. Particles can also fracture because of animals burrowing or by the pressure put forth by growing roots. Second point, movement and mixing of materials. Many large soil organisms cause the movement of soil particles. This movement can introduce the material to different weathering processes found at distinct location in the soil profile. Simple chemical processes like solutions can be enhanced by the carbon dioxide produced by respiration. Carbon dioxide mixing with water forms carbonic acid. The complex chemical effects that occurs as a result of chelation. Chelation is a biological process where organisms produce organic substance known as chelates that have the ability to decompose minerals and rocks by the removal of metallic cation. Organisms can influence the moisture regime in soils and therefore enhance weathering. Shade from aerial leaves and stems The presence of root masses and humus all acts to increase the availability of water in the soil profile. Water is a necessary component in several physical and chemical weathering processes. Organisms can influence the pH of the soil solution. Respiration from plant roots release carbon dioxide. If the carbon dioxide mixes with water, carbonic acid is formed, which lowers the soil pH. Cation exchange reactions by which plants absorb nutrients from the soil can also cause pH changes. The absorption processes often involves the exchange of basic cations for hydrogen ions. Generally, the higher the concentration of hydrogen ions, the more acidic a soil becomes. So, these are also some of the important points that should be included in the biological weathering process. So, in the conclusion, we can say that plants and animals, they also plays an important role in the transformation of soil. Whereas, while transforming, soil can also increase it or enrich itself by increasing its drainage property and nutrients within the soil. On the other hand, men are also responsible for the transformation of soil, either positively or negatively, through their different activities like over-cultivation, construction, excessive use of fertilizers, which all to cause or put great pressure on the soil physical and chemical properties. Other factors like filling, mining and drainage also put a great impact on the soil formation process. In total, if we conclude or if we observe, man is the only creature which is causing beneficial or tremendous effect on the soil formation and soil transformation process. Thanks.